note of a group called South Sea Revival Crusade, which started in the early 1960s.
Around 1960, I met Bob and Anne Searle in the Glory Revival Convention in Newark. And sort of a link was formed.
And we would come together annually in that area for tent crusades on the common in South Sea. And a number of us gathered there. There were seven main people and a number of others who were there as well. And those seven were ministers from around the British Isles, and they had powerful ministries in their own right, but they were independent. But at that time, the baptism of the Holy Spirit wasn't too well regarded in the traditional churches, and each one felt the need for prayer covering.
We felt a need to belong and to be identified with other like-minded brothers, sisters who were in ministry or workers.
And in 1967, because it had spread and we were covering far more territory than the south of England, and we were travelling together occasionally as little teams, even to Europe and so on, we to expand it. And as we prayed and waited on God, God gave us the name International Gospel Outreach.
And thank God this morning He did. And because He did, and rose again from the dead, we have the victory. The victory that overcomes the world. And it's our faith. Our faith in the risen, glorious Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. It's really good to be with you and to have you present in this conference. And I'm sure that God has a specific purpose for this conference. In the ongoingness of God's purposes, there's always something related to the present tense. And God has something for you, for me, for us collectively, right here in this conference. And we don't want to miss that. We want to receive it. We want to be open for it. And the Holy Spirit is here to bring forth the manifestation of God's purpose for our lives and for our conference.
There's only one church. We read about it in the book of Hebrews. It says it's the church of the firstborn.
And I'm so happy that the Lord has granted me this privilege through the responsible brethren and sisters and so on. And I pray that God will use me to be a mouthpiece for God. If I can sow some seeds of what truth and light and revelation, something that will be meaningful for you and to you in days to come, I'll be very, very happy.